The game of rugby is one of the world's most brutal. No helmets, no padding. Just 30 guys scrambling after a ball in shorts that are way too tight. The rugby team from Simi Valley U had lost their 15th game in a row that afternoon. But that didn't stop them from celebrating. They were far better partiers than they were rugby players. In the last 5 minutes, John had botched a crucial scoring play and lost the game. On the field, John couldn't hold on to the ball. And at parties, he couldn't hold his liquor.
You're like a galaxy of freckles.
Hey, man, come on.
With more beer in his veins than blood, John was all shook up and ready to blow.
What's your problem?
He was like an open can of buzzkill.
An individual who may become a bully may have already struggled with low self-esteem issues, and in order to feel better about themselves, they use this anger and aggression as a means to put other people down and to lift themselves up, in a sense.
This beer's cold! I want some English beer, mate. Let's warm it up a bit.
If you ever want to break up a beach party, just throw the keg in the fire.
Come on, man. Hey, the party's just getting started. Come on.
John stuck around because somebody had to die in this story. The fire heated the keg to 700 degrees Celsius. The pressure inside went from 25 psi to 600 pounds of beer pressure per square inch. The superheated keg exploded, sending razor-sharp pieces of aluminum shrapnel deep into John's chest.
Comparing a heated keg to an exploding device, I think the closest thing to it would be a giant hand grenade almost. I think that's really what that became, because it created shrapnel that could sever a limb or do an incredible amount of tissue damage when it goes inside the body.
Anyone who knew him thought John was a total dick.
You're like a galaxy of freckles.
The silver lining in this beer cloud. At least he didn't take anyone else with him.